So let us now learn about elapsed time. What is this elapsed time? In our previous video, we have seen if you want to display the current date and time and then make the program sleep for certain seconds and display the rest date and time, how do you do that? Whereas in case of this program, we want to learn what is the difference of those milliseconds when the thread was run at the starting and then after the 3 seconds. So when the thread run starting, that is when you print at the current date and time, there would have been certain milliseconds, right? And when you again run the program after 3 seconds, there is again certain milliseconds. What is the difference between each of these milliseconds and how you can call the milliseconds with the help of current time millis method? So we have first imported the package called java.util.asterisk, and then we have created a class called difference demo. This difference demo will enable you to find the difference between the milliseconds of the previous and then the current date and time. So first we have used a variable which is of a long type, okay? Until now we've been using int, string, boolean, double, decimal and all, and now the value that you receive in milliseconds may be larger than int, right? So we need to store the information which is larger than int, which is of an integer format, therefore we are using a long data type. So the data type, and then you provide the variable name we have provided at start. And now in this variable which is start, we are trying to store the current milliseconds. And how do you store? From the system you are trying to get. So you write system dot current time millis, right? You are calling this method over the system to store or to get the current time milliseconds and store it in this variable. Okay, so now you have the start time, and now let us print the date and time. So how do you print the date and time? By using a new keyword which you call to create a new object of your date type. So this is how you print your current date and time. So first is completed. Our first task was to print the current date and time and to get the milliseconds at that particular date and time. Now we are making a thread sleep because we want to get the date and time later, that is after 3 seconds. So we call the sleep method over the thread class and with the value of milliseconds, that is you making your computer program to sleep for 3 seconds. Now after the computer program slept for 3 seconds, we are again printing the date and time at that particular time. So we have created a new date object. So once you have created, what was your second task? The first task was to print the current date and time and get the milliseconds and store it in a variable. And then the second task was to get the date and time after the 3 seconds and save the milliseconds again in some other variable. So we created a variable which is a data type of long, and the variable name is end. And now after the 3 seconds, we are getting the milliseconds of the system and storing. So what are we saying? That now the time is at 1:05, right? 1:05, and then what is the second? It is 45 seconds. Then what is the millisecond? Again 10 seconds. So you are getting that 10 seconds, and after few seconds, that is after 3 seconds, that is after 45 plus 3, 48, what are the milliseconds? And if it is again 11, what is the difference between this millisecond and the after milliseconds, that is after 3 seconds of your program slept? So to find out the difference, we subtract the current millisecond with the 3 second previous milliseconds, that is end minus start, and store it in a long variable because the data that you are holding in end and start is of long type. And now once you get the data, you can print the difference of your milliseconds. And once if there is any exception, it will be handled in your catch block, which is your one type of exception handler. So this is how you get your milliseconds and then find out the difference between the milliseconds by making your program sleep for certain period of time. So let us execute our program practically to understand how you can make your program sleep for certain seconds and how you can calculate the difference of milliseconds, that is before and after. This program helps us in understanding how can we calculate the elapsed time or the difference time between two moments. Okay, so we have certain classes available
like system.nanotime and system.currentTimeMillis. Both of them can be used to calculate the time difference, but the nanotime will exactly measure the elapsed time because it retrieves the value from the computer time, and whereas current time millis calculate or measure the time difference from the wall clock time. So if you need the exact measurement, it is better to use nanotime, or if you are okay to get any result, you can use current time millis. So here again we have used try catch block to understand if there is any error in the try block, please catch the exception in catch block. So we have created a class called elapsed time with the main method and try catch block. In the try block, what we first do is that first we need to get the current time. Once you get the current time and make your system sleep for a certain period of time, only then you can get the time of the other second. That is, what is your purpose here? To calculate the difference between two moments. That is, now you are sleeping, after 2 hours you get up, what is the time at that time? Okay, so for example, if it is 11 o'clock now, you're sleeping for half an hour, so you need to get the time after half an hour. And to get the time after half an hour, you need to make your system sleep for half an hour and then retrieve the value after half an hour, which will be 11:30. So your intention here is to identify how much or what is the elapsed time between these. So what was the difference time between from 11 to 11:30? So let us see an example. We are trying to get the current time from the system. So system.currentTimeMillis. And this value will store in start variable, which is of a data type called log, which stores an int value. So you have stored in start. Now what you're doing is that you're trying to print what is the value in your start, or what is the current, the present date, the time, seconds and everything it will display. Next step, you're trying to make your system sleep for 3 seconds. How do you calculate? 5 into 60, 300, 300 into 10 is 3000, and where 1000 milliseconds is equal to 1 second, therefore 3000 milliseconds would be 3 seconds. You can also write here 3000 milliseconds because the value is always taken in the milliseconds. Then you're trying to display the date after 3 seconds. So what was the value of your date before 3 seconds? And when your system slept for 3 seconds, after 3 seconds, what was the date, time and all, you need to display that. Now, how do you calculate the difference between these two? You have saved the start value, the current value. Now, you have to save the end value. So, after you have made your system sleep for 3 seconds, what is the date? What is the time? You're saving that to your end variable, that is of long data type. We create another variable to identify the difference between the start and the end time. So how do you calculate? You create another variable called long, the variable name as difference, and you subtract from end to start, end minus start, and we will display the value in system.outprintln. The difference is so and so. It is very simple. You can just see what we do is that we write int a, or we say long a is equal to 10. Okay. And then we say long b is equal to 20. So what should be long c? What is the value of long c? We say b minus a. This is how simple you write even for your time. What you do is that instead of A, you get your start time, you get the start time from your system, and then you get your end time again from the system, and then you calculate your difference value which is stored in A and B. Let us save this program and see. Control S, F11. So if you see, first your program displayed the current date and time as 30 seconds, and with a sleep of 3 seconds, then it displayed the date and time with the second. So your first system.outprintln printed the current date and time, and after sleeping for 3 seconds, again it displayed the date and time with value. So next our step was to calculate the elapsed time or the difference time between the end and the start. It says that 3016, where 3000 was your milliseconds and 16 seconds were taken to print this.